This is not the most exciting hand, but I'm gonna keep it. I think it would be fair to Morgan actually, because balance might not be very good. And we don't have any green mana or anything to play before turn 4 at the earliest, so this would have been fair to Morgan. So maybe we'll just try to lose this quick. TBH. There's a green, which helps. Gonna lead with the darker ways, so we could play balance off of another land, or we could play mana drain if we draw it, or we could abort and play a green card. Soul Ring. Yeah, I don't really want to balance that bad because the opponent gets to keep Soul Ring. See if we can save it for a rainy day. Keep shipping the turn. Yeah, it draws horrendously bad. This was a questionable keep, no doubt. Maybe the opponent will get out a Sundering Titan. We can balance our way out of it. No attacks from the Welder. No play whatsoever. Good for us. Gives us more time to develop. I'm interested in playing. I would be interested in playing Chromox into Harmonize, but really want to play. Don't want to Wheel of Fortune at all. Just gonna pass the turn, to be honest. Like, getting rid of the Mirari's Wake would be fine, but that's probably just our best card, and that's the only way we can play Harmonize. So I would rather not. Memory Jar. That's a sweet one. I'm not sure how that interacts with balance exactly. I do know that between Wheel of Fortune and Brain Freeze, we're going to have a chance of milling the opponent out. Do nothing. Hope to God draw a land. God. Gonna play Chromox and Imprint and empty the Warrens. Gonna pass the turn so that we have mana next turn to play Brain Freeze if we need to. And then Imprinting the Empty the Warrens so that we have mana to play Wheel of Fortune. Basically try to go the mill you out route. It's just gonna be interesting. Trying to make something out of not very much here. Big turn coming. Alright, here it comes. What is this? Dak Faden is annoying as hell. Things are not going optimally. I think we're gonna have to move to a third game. Balance is not really the solution here. We're a million miles away from doing anything. Stuck on mana. Probably a bad keep, to be honest. I'm considering conceding just because we have so little time and this game's feeling pretty hopeless. Here's an island. Still cannot play anything. I guess at this point, in the last turn as well, Sphinx's Revelation for one might have been smart. End of the turn. Just, increase our, just get rid of it, right? We've got Harmonize, which does the same thing. We've got Wheel of Fortune. I think we could win this game with the mill route, though. Definitely feels possible. The opponent doesn't know. Opponent pitches Mastercore. That thing could come back and it could be angry. Mishra's Workshop. I imagine a lot's going to go wrong here. Tangle Wire. That's a tough one. Could be time to just start F6ing pretty soon. Imperial Recruiter. Sweet deck from the opponent. I guess we're getting some information. I think it's probably smart to save as much time as possible and just scoop, though. Or maybe try to make the opponent work for it. Huntmaster of the Fells, huh? See if the opponent plays all this stuff. We can. Well, with Tangle Wire, we're not doing anything, so why don't we actually just concede? 2, 3, 4. Oops, it's still the main phase, so Thupon was playing around mana drain, they can now not play around mana drain. Tap these. I'm just gonna concede, guys. It's coming down to time. This game seemed pretty unwinnable, and I want to make sure we have time for game three. So that game, something like Force of Will in hand could have been nice, but I still think Elspeth is the thing we want, as it can clear all those artifacts. We don't have, don't want the Oblivion Ring or D-Sphere, so let's just submit with what we have.